Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this has been your True Nerd, and welcome to Yooka Laylee, or should I say Banjo Kazooie 2, or I suppose I should say Banjo Kazooie 3, or I suppose I should say Banjo 3, because that's pretty much the naming convention they did already establish for that franchise. Yes, Yooka Laylee is just pretty much Banjo Kazooie. This was a kickstarted game where they basically said, we want to make a new Banjo Kazooie, and they did, down to every last detail. Like, the menus look exactly like Banjo Kazooie's did, where if you actually kind of go down, the characters make their little noises. See, when you hover over the menu, they go to the right thing. Also, there's even a character like on one of these things that sounds exactly like Gruntilda. This dinosaur here, that's just Gruntilda, alright? That is just Gruntilda as a dinosaur. Also, it's more than coincidence there's a flipping feather there as well, I'm sure of it. Now, as for me, I loved Banjo-Kazooie. Banjo-Kazooie was great. 90s platformers in general were great at the time. Interesting thing about Yooka-Laylee, though, it's been getting really mixed reviews. Some people love it, some people really don't like it. And, well, 90s platformers, it's, you know, not the 90s anymore. Some things age well, some things don't. Let's figure out whether this one has. I'm gonna be honest, the dramatic music doesn't really suit the nice, sunny environment. Ah, that's better. Maybe don't focus on the nice sunny bit at the top. Just focus on the horrible thing that's... That sludge was just producing the letter N. Everything has been prepared to your specification, capital B. The workforce is now yours. Do you think this new statue is golden enough? Or too golden? Focus tested. These employees need someone to look up to. Hold on. What is that? Oh, the Vice President put his own little statue there. That's the Vice President statue, sir. I didn't sign off on that. Plus, it's casting an awkward shadow on the President's plinth. Now, are we ready to synergize your latest profit-plumping technology, Dr. Quack? Yes, sir, I have prepared the Novelizer 64, my most ingenious invention. We can use it to steal all the dusty old books in the world and leave us as the only player in the market. An equally ruthless and dynamic strategy, Doctor. I like it. And that explains why the letters were coming out of the sludge earlier. We're literally pulping books into little floating letters. Marvellous. And Quack, make sure you secure the special book. You know, this makes Banjo's quest look relatively petty. He was just trying to save his sister. In this case, we're trying to literally save all literature in the world. And there we are. There's our heroes, Yooka and Laylee. Oh, they've got matching towels. And Laylee the tiny bat has actually got the bigger towel. That's somehow adorable. Excellent. So, welcome to Yooka Laylee. It's Banjo-Kazooie, but ooh, it's really, really damn pretty and runs at 60 FPS and 1080p and so forth. Because, yeah, you go back and play Banjo-Kazooie and N64 now. Very, very, very low resolution. The N64 was only 240p. Go play the Rare Replay version instead. That's nice and high res. So as a starting point, we can literally only do two things. We can move around, we can jump, double jump, and I can also stick my tongue out. It's not exactly that impressive there, Yooka. I was kind of hoping you'd be able to stick your tongue out further, but what have you? Ooh, it's pretty and lovely, and I like it already because it's gorgeous. This in my brain is how Banjo-Kazooie and Super Mario 64 still look. They definitely don't, but batshit crazy. Ah, that old Rare humour is back again, lovely. So we can see where the pages are going this direction, but looks like we've got a locked door in our way. Hello there, Mr. Whoever you are that locks the doors on this occasion. What do you need me to... He's a snake, and he's bent round so he can wear shorts. That's amazing. Hello! Hi there, I'm Yooka, this is my buddy Laylee. Do we know you? Of course, it's me, Trouser... Trouser the snake. Oh, guys, the honest and dexterous salesman. Yeah, I remember. You're the crook who sold us that dodgy flat screen. Nope, not me. You're surely mistaken, friend. Hey, Trouser, do you happen to see a magical flying book go through here? For 5 quills I did. They're in demand now this book business has kicked off. Perhaps you can find enough in those treasure chests lying around. Okay, so open treasure chest, get him quills, hand those over, he'll help me, lovely. To unlock them, you need one of my trademark specials. Okay, so you're just Bottles the Mole for this game, got it. Except mysteriously, you just have a giant mobile phone you get out occasionally. Press X, our green friend here can perform a tail twirl attack. It's smashing, lovely. So, chest here, swing into that, crack it open, and bring me a feather, which is quill. Oh, it's sentient. It's got eyes and it can speak, and I'm about to sell it into slavery. Oh, well, never mind. So now I can do an attack on the ground, or if I'm jumping, I can do a, ooh, spinny attack in the air. I like that. That's pretty cool. Right, just start smashing open some stuff here, find treasure chest, crack them open, get quills, sell to that guy. Gotcha. Also smash open barrels? Yes, I can. And I get a butterfly. And this is a tasty butterfly energy. Be nice and collect meat to refill your power bar. Good. Third one over here by the tree. Pretty sure I saw a couple of these on our boat as well. Yep, one right up here. Up to five. Lovely. Ah, yes, that seems to be enough to jog my memory. Come back here. Lovely. So if my attack's actually the spin attack, what exactly is me putting my tongue out for? Can I just put my tongue out because I enjoy putting my tongue out? Probably. Also, I swear I saw an extra... Yeah, it's more than just what we've seen already. There's extra quills over here. I'm getting all the quills, damn it. Right, I've got eight, and until I figure out how to climb, which I assume is going to be a move he's just going to teach me, I don't think I can get up there because this up here is a slippery, slidey slope. So can't do anything with that just yet. Fine. All right, Snakey, spill the beans. Where is our book? Your book headed towards the business beyond this gate. Strange things going on there since the takeover by Hivory Towers Corp. I'm headed there myself to sell some moves. Allow me to raise the gate. There we go. Lovely. So, look out for this guy. Give him quills. Get moves. Gotcha. To get across the next gap, we'll need to use A to jump. Okay, this game is, you know, just assuming maybe possibly you haven't played a platform before. I'm guessing this up here is too steep to jump up. Yep, too steep. Maybe if I jump, jump, and do a spin attack. Yes, you totally can. Nice. And we've got some little blue things up ahead looking even shiftier than Trouser. Maybe the lost. No, maybe we just need to murder them. Hello there, not friends. Yep, we'll just hit you and hit you and job done. And they produce butterflies. Butterflies get my health back. Oh, I got little kind of boggly eyes before they attack you. That's cute. We're searching for our missing book. It looked like it went this way. Your book belongs to us now, as will most of the world's supply before long. Mwahaha! There's something not right about this place, Laylee. We should investigate. Yes, indeed we should, Yooka. Let's get on it. And, oh, we can go in here if we want. Oh, I think I might have accidentally just found my way forward a bit. Hang on, I'm going to go see what I missed earlier. Ah, nothing much here. It's just teaching me how to crouch, to get under things, how to jump over things. Basic movement tutorial. But yeah, if you can just basically master the double jump followed by the attack, you can just skip all of this, which I approve of. And then just swimming to get underneath. Fine. Or even just the classic N64 platformer thing of the music's like this, but then when you dive underwater, the music immediately converts into like the submerged form of the same tune, which is just beautiful. Hivory Towers, right, this might well be the equivalent of Grunty's Lair. Hey friends, over here. Trouser, are you on our side? Because I'm not convinced you are 100%, though I love the way you wear shorts. Now Trouser spotted a piece of our book, lovely, and where is it? Is it up top? On top of the statue. Got it. Just need to climb up there. So, first of all, of course, can we destroy the tiny Dr. Quack statue? No, tragically, we cannot. So, it's just beautifully designed, isn't it? Because, you know, the villain's the bee. So, it's all like, yeah, it's like a hive and the books floating around. And okay, so, we're going to need the move to climb the kind of steep things before we can get up here. Sadly, that one you can't just skip. So, probably that's going to be the first move he teaches. Basically, he's going to teach us the Talon Trot. Except not the Talon Trot, because none of those have got talons. Unless bats have talons. I don't think they do, but I can't really be sure. Right, so, platform. Ah! Platform with a little red thing becomes green and smiley when you step on it. That's cute. Oh no, that one's sad. Okay. Don't know how you tell which one's going to be happy and which one's going to be sad, but what have you. We've got, ooh, pretty water effects. Nice. Right, some nice basic platforming here. The fact that we've got... Oh! Nice basic platforming, I say, failing to do it. That's more like it. Right, over, double jump, over here. Get the camera nice and high, and that's fine. And up top we go. This is our first jiggy. Sorry, pagey. I prefer the little dance the banjo did, damn it. And I'm a pagey, I live inside the all-powerful One Book. The One Book? How much is one of those worth? The One Book is incredibly powerful, and it's been stolen by the evil Capital B. If Capital B unlocks the power within his crooked company, we'll have the power to rewrite the universe. Luckily, us Pages have fled the One Book and gone into hiding. Without Pages, the One Book is just an empty shell. If you use me to unlock one of the grand tomes in this factory, we can transport to another world and search for more of my friends. Marvelous. We'll help you, Pagey. Come on, Laylee. Let's find one of those grand tomes and search for more Pages. That seems like a good idea. How about, say, 10 Pages per world, 9 or so worlds? That's normally about right for this sort of thing. And Trouser, of course, wants to sell us a new move. Lovely. Say, you two chaps need to explore those grand tomes, and I'm looking to expand my businesses to new locations. How about we make a deal? For every grand tome you unlock, I'll help your quest with a new move free of charge. Alright, sounds like a good deal to me. Your first complimentary move is one of my trademark abilities. If you hold down RT, you'll get the grip you need to roll up slippery ramps. And I'm guessing I also move a little bit faster than usual because it's just going to be the Talon Trot, isn't it? There's one note in the small print, pals. The longer you use the move, the more you'll drain your power bar, so roll wisely. Oh, okay, sorry, the butterflies top up presumably stamina, not health. And up the ramp, we do indeed have the first grand tome. Lovely, so hold this down. And now we are rolling and we have got ourselves, yes indeed, a little power bar that I'm guessing is a stamina meter. And ooh, you move at a nice pelt, that's good. We've got a page in a KG, amazing. Right, let's get it out if we can. So Captain B's corplet minions have locked me in this metal prison. And how are we going to get you out then, Pagey? There's no key. KGs are unlocked by solving nearby puzzles, but you've not learned the correct move to help me. Alright, fine, we'll come back for you later then. Also, can't help but feel, you're made of paper, right? Like, you're incredibly thin. Like, I feel like if you just turn, in fact, don't even bother turning sideways, just literally walk slightly to your left or your right now, you will actually get through. This is a really bad prison for a piece of paper. I see, so basically I just need to learn the Beak Buster, or whatever this game's gonna call it, and then spell Pagey. Got it, that's a ridiculously Banjo-Kazooie puzzle right there. Anyway, up we go, lovely, and there we are. Use the Pagey, open the Grand Tome, let's go into our first world. So it cost me my one page to open the book. Oh, go on then, it seems like a sort of thing I'd want to do. So we've got our first world there, marvellous, and well, before we go in there, anything else we can do out here? None of that. I can totally get up here a little bit though. Nope, that tube is slippery. I'm going to need a new move before I can get through there. Fine, in which case, into the first world we go. I swear that's the exact same sound effect that plays when you enter a world in Banjo-Kazooie. Welcome to Tribal Stack Tropics, and oh wow, it's pretty. In fact, actually, it's very Snake Pass. It looks a lot like Snake Pass, in fact. So, we've got a ton of quills here. That's fine, and oop, no, that is slippery. Fine, up we go then. Grab all the quills, and I missed one. That's more like it. Up we go, and are you bad guys? You bad guys? Yeah, you know, I'm going to attack you anyway. Yep, that was the right thing to do. Now, I think I realize what's going on here. Oh, no. No, it's wrong. I was about to say, I think I realize what's going on here, which is butterflies. So you don't pick them up by accident. You need to use your tongue on them to eat them. No. You eat them anyway. So what's the tongue for? I thought I had that figured out there. Also, even though they're kind of like quills and feathers, they actually, I swear, they make the musical notes noise, or very close to it, for Banjo-Kazooie. I mean, that doesn't really feel like the sort of noise a quill would make. It feels like the sort of noise that, you know, a musical note would make, which would be what you were picking up if you were playing Banjo-Kazooie, which I effectively am, just in the future. And, ooh, there's a thing here. Hello. What's one of you? Are you a ginger? Ghostwriters are we, this book we made, 305, and a treasure will trade. Yes, indeed. They're the gingers. Except, unlike the gingers, they actually don't want to be caught. They actually will run away from you a bit. So, three main ways you can go. A ruin over there, a big old thing over here, including... what is that at the front? You look like a friendly character because you know you've got some sort of face. Or something up here. This one seems closest. Let's start up here in that case. And that is... We've run into you. Gosh, I seem to have got myself into a pot of bother. Oh, the terrible puns. I like the terrible puns. Ooh, the cauldron's speaking too. No need for name calling. Oh, he doesn't like being called a pot of bother. I like the cauldron more than the explorer skeleton already. Ah, okay, hang on. No, I have figured this out. So, if you run into a butterfly, it gives you your energy back. So, go into... No, don't miss. There we are, that gets your energy back. But if you eat a butterfly, you don't get energy back, but you get health back instead. Gotcha. Now, what do you two need me to do? Or rather, I'm guessing technically, each of you probably wants to do something different. And that's because you don't want to be a pod. Maybe you want to be something else. Maybe you want to be an architect. I can help with that too. Cripes, thank goodness you're here. I've been kidnapped by these things. They're going to cook me. Might be a bit late for that, to be honest. If they're hungry, they'll need a character a bit more fleshed out than you. I immediately like this game. Help me escape, I'll reward you with a pagey. Marvellous. Now, how do I help you escape, then? But be quick, my captors will be back any minute with their condiments. Well, that's fine, we just need to... Yeah, you know what? Yes, and then just use my spin attack, that should be fine. Feels like it's got, like, a good area effect around you, and you can use it without using stamina, so we can probably just murder a whole lot of things. So, just round and about, murder everyone. But yeah, you've got a nice area of effect on all this. Actually, if you roll into them, is that good enough? Hello, hang on. You're over there, aren't you? Yep, roll. Yep, a roll is... Ah, it stuns. It doesn't kill. Fine. And more coming in. Yeah, let's go for a triple. Oh, or rather like a zero stun, because I missed absolutely all of you. Stun. Screw you. Boom. And ouch. Boom. And boom. And then eat the butterfly. Get my health back. Looks like dinner's cancelled. Jay, give me a page of you. Admittedly, you're still tied in the pot and you haven't actually escaped and you are dead, but you know what, whatever, give me the pagey anyway. Please take your reward. You earned it. Yay, pagey. Why don't you do a little dance? That's the one bit of Banjo-Kazooie you should have definitely kept, doing a little dance. That was great. That might not be everything here, though. Feels like, yeah, there's a path over here to the right of all of this. Don't go too much along here, though, or we will... What's this for? This must be here for something. There's a block here, and there's a path. Why? Why is that here? That must be here for some reason. I can see how... Okay, so I can get under here. Fine, there's a little kind of path underneath here. Does this go anywhere? No. Doesn't seem to. Up, and no, hang on, I can get this. Up, and attack. Lovely. Right, feel like we're done with this area. On to the next of two, and hopefully pretty soon we will find Trouser, who can teach us a new move. All right, 10 quid says this is going to be Cloudy the Cloud. Hello, who are you? Hello, this is Laylee, I'm Yooka. Who might you be? I'm Nimble. Oh, gosh darn it, Nimbus Cloud. Darn it, I was close-ish. How about we see who is the most racy, you know, in a race around my course? Oh, go on then, sure, why not? So what we need to do is follow, well, obviously, you know, the rings have little eyes on them because it's Banjo-Kazooie logic, so literally everything has little eyes on it. Hopefully there'll be butterflies on it which can top up my stamina. And go! Nice, right through here, yeah, through the butterflies, keep the stamina topped up. And through, and I'm running low on stamina up here, but there is some butterflies up ahead. Boom, lovely, get the quills as well while we're passing through this dry riverbed around here, and we are by now miles ahead, lovely. Grab, missed one, but that's fine, there's some up here, nice. Looks like you found enough quills for my first move, lovely, so he does indeed have a requirement before he'll let you have the move. Grab those, and at this point I am in fact out of energy. Need to hopefully... Yep, good. I was far enough around, even though I missed a couple of butterflies. Lovely. Impressive. Can't believe you finished ahead of me. Just give me the damn pagey, you. Yeah, Laylee even basically has the personality of Kazooie, because Kazooie was always the more kind of like sarcastic and mercenary one, and Banjo is much more helpful and earnest, so they literally have the same personalities as Banjo-Kazooie did. And he is going to rain a pagey down on us. Marvellous. I feel a bit weird about that, actually. I'm not sure about that at all, but whatever. By any chance, you have a second race for us, because sometimes in this sort of game, characters have a second faster race afterwards for, like, a secondary prize. We can't race again while the track's in this state, silly. Come back next season. Ah! We're going to do something in this level that's going to fill up this river, and once we're done with that, then we can return. Gotcha. Now, next up, we've got this big old building in the centre. Ah! With plenty of pages floating around the top of it. This feels important. Right. Big building here. Nice ramp. Oh, no. Definitely a proper ramp that needs to be spared up. Lovely. Into the top over here. And what is this? Hello? Can we speak to you? Can we wake you up? No. You're not awake right now. Up here. as a result, wait, I heard a phone. A phone means Trouser. Where's Trouser got himself to? There he is. Hello, Trouser. So he actually has a selection of moves we can buy. The Buddy Slam, smashing move. Okay, exactly what we need to free that pagey earlier that we saw. Slurp Shot, slurp up edible objects and then fire projectiles. Or Sonar Shot, shoot super sonar shots to show secrets. Let's go for the Beak Buster, because that's always very, very useful in this sort of game. So now we jump and we slam. Lovely. Very good indeed. Can we slam these right now? Normally you can. Ah, okay, there's someone down there who actually wants me to break these. Fine, hello, I'll just break all these for you then. Smash, and over here, and smash, lovely. Final one, up and smash. Hello there, who are you, what do you want? Capital Work, come inside and we'll arrange a sporting contest for a real prize. What ho! Okay, fine. Find a way downstairs and, okay. Now we can go in there, that door at the front, and there's something in there for me. Lovely. First, do you have anything I can do with you, my good man? Nope, not even body slamming on him does anything. This guy just refuses to wake up. Now, there was someone else up here. There was a character on a balcony at the front, wasn't there? Yeah. Hello, you. Right, we'll come to you in a second, but there's a bunch of quills I want to get on all the corners first. Right, hello there. Who are you and what do you do? In fact, what the hell are you even supposed to be? Hey, kids, what can I get you? An explanation as to what the bloody hell you even are. One tonic. You've got to present your company-approved ID card first, kid. Ivory Towers employees only. Ah, it's about that my bat friend here ate mine. Tell you what, I'll let you off just this once. We're all friendly colleagues after all. What are you? Are you a fridge? A fridge wearing a thing but yellow and with a face? I guess? The name's Vendy. Oh, you're a vending machine. You don't look anything like a vending machine, but all right. I assume you're familiar with my game-modifying tonics. Remember, each tonic you equip makes a big change to your rules of work. You need to complete a challenge to unlock each one, and no messing around, only one tonic equipped at a time. Come see me when you want to swap them out. Lovely. I see. If I complete challenges, I get special abilities that I can equip to change how I'm playing. Got it. So, gain a butterfly health slot, and I need to collect 5 pages for that. Okay, so have myself a tiny bit more health, or stun 30 enemies to unlock the Super Slam Tonic, and that means that I gain a more powerful Buddy Slam. Gotcha. So, we let the lighting under here. Let's see what's going on underneath the ruin. Duke's Temple. Okay, the posh chap who we spoke to is Duke. He's got a pagey and a cagey. Probably we should go and sort that out then. Hello there, what do you want me to do? Good day, strapping adventurer. Splendid day for our hunt, whatnot. So he proposes I take on his target challenge. Though I suspect I may need, like, the sucking things up and firing them ability before I can do this. Yes, indeed. Good grief, you're not even qualified for shooting. I believe a visit to that Trouser chap should set you straight, pip pip. Fine. So come back here when we've got another 30 quills. And as a result, we can do, yeah, we can basically grab these and then just kind of spit them at whatever shows up over there. Gotcha. So let's get ourselves some quills by just jumping around here. We've got ourselves quite a few of them. Never mind. And then we've got ourselves another ghostwriter here. Just go and grab, or not. You want to be fed, I'm guessing. Put something, okay, fine. So probably we need to grab the, kind of grabbing those crystal coconuts, because they're blazing crystal coconuts, and then kind of tossing one in his mouth. Fine, we'll come back for you later. Also, we've got Planty the Plant here. What do you want, Planty the Plant? Sorry, I've got no business with you, lizard. Okay, fine, so I need to find Mumbo and turn myself into a plant so he'll speak to me. Gotcha, we'll come back for that then. So round here, plenty more of these lads. Yeah, lovely. Nope, up we go to you. But just up here, this way, and then roly roll. Lovely, and don't go too far or fast. Right, up and up. And one more of you, and up and up. And we have almost the 30 we need. Now we just go through here. Oh yeah, those spit flames. I missed that. Luckily made it pass fast enough, really. And through that, no, never mind. And now finally we're almost at the top of the pyramid over here. Swing and swing to take your, ooh, you're a bit tougher. You took 2 hits, damn it. Right, eat that, get a tiny bit of health back. And then up, up and jump and, can't quite get up there. Oh, I may need like a double jump before I can get up that high. Except there's clearly over there a bit of an indent. And this over here, okay, I'd like to think this is going to be where I'm supposed to be going. Yep, or rather possibly. This might just be an Easter egg rather than where I'm supposed to go. Darn it, I mean to come back when I've got like my double jump sorted out for that in that case. Can I stand on top of the trees, by the way? And kite? No, not really. Ah, this is interesting. We've got a pagey and a cagey, but the cagey's broken, and to be honest, so's the pagey too. No, how do we find your other half? I'm a pagey piece. I got torn up by capital B's enforcers and thrown in this jungle. My other pieces have been scattered nearby. Fine, please find my other three pieces, then I'll be whole again. Gotcha. There we are, there's one. Right, keep searching around in this area for more pages. There might be one back there though. Yep, right in the middle of all these bushes. There's two. And there's the third one just up there. Fine, up there. I can see there's a ghost rush appearing, disappearing down there. I'm not sure how we get him. Right, there's the third piece there. Return to you. That is all of them. Hello. Now, let's rebuild you and then immediately grab you and then you're just coming with me, all right? Finally, I'm free. You're not free. You're coming with us. Sorry. Not for long, Goldie. Yep, would you believe that Laylee has the exact same plan as me? Good, good. You're mine now. And it looks like you found enough pages to expand a world. Yay, I'm guessing that just means go and open a new thing. Another plant here that I'm guessing doesn't want to speak to me because I'm not a plant myself. Is that going to be true? Sorry, no business with you. Yes, indeed. I suspect I need to find whatever this game's version of Mumbo is and turn myself into a plant. Lovely. Right, this time let's head over to the right from where I started. Sticking up top, yeah, heading over. Ooh, this I like. Okay, yeah, lots of bottomless pits. The bottomless pits are back from the N64 days. So this is obviously the track that I raced through earlier. We've also got, ooh, a giant arcade machine here. Very nice. And I finally figured out what the tongue is for. The tongue gets mysteriously longer when Yooka wants to eat the butterflies. Beautiful. And you are the dinosaur from the start screen that just sounds just like flipping Gruntilda. Also, you are a weird old-fashioned liney dinosaur. Excellent. This is basically just a CRT monitor dinosaur, aren't you? Hello there, strange polygonal dinosaur. Are you sure you're in the right game or decade? Oh, bless, he looks fine. He's just a little bit polygonal. He's all right. He is Rextro the retro dinosaur. Beautiful. Rextro crowdfunded return. Got cool old school games to play. Rextro had to borrow assets from other games, but don't tell. Friends will need play coin to make sure arcade works. Retro sure he saw one near here. Fine, get a coin, then we can play his game. I presume you get a pagey. Got a bunch of plants here, but nothing we can do with them just yet. More notes here. Is that a flipping... I think it's a spaceship over there. Yep, let's go investigate the... No. It's a weird ray gun thing. Can I stand right in the middle and do something? Oh, you're an alien. Hello there, Mr. Alien. Tell me what's going on here then. I am Dr. Puzz, Ivory Tower's top scientist. Well, I used to be before that dastardly Dr. Quack stole all of my research. Oh, Dr. Quack, I knew he was a bad egg. Because he's a duck. Sorry, this game, it makes me make even worse puns than usual. I've just been tweaking my favourite invention, which has the magnificent power to transform- Okay, so you're Mumbo Jumbo for this game, gotcha. Can you turn me into a plant, bunny chance? Because the plants are being really sniffy about speaking to me when I'm a lizard. So I need to find a molecule I can power up the DN ray and help you on your adventure. Marvellous. Not sure what exactly a molecule is, but I'm guessing- Oh wait, no! I do know what this is. It was in the- It's probably in the thing, quite frankly. If I just keep going into the options menu, I'll see it eventually. No, it's refusing to show up, but I saw it on the main menu. It's just a thing that looks like an atom. We just need to find a thing that looks like an atom. Gotcha. And with this one here, we've got- Ooh. This is going to be a bit tricky to get to. If I go to- You and then to here, I could miss both of them, of course I could. Right, you however, nothing I can do for you just yet, so I solve a nearby puzzle. Okay, just jump and jump, there we go, got both of them, suck up the butterflies. What's the puzzle this thing wants me to solve? Not obvious yet, fine, let's go back over here for a second. Jumpy. Then over to here, and then jump to yet another one. Don't fall off. Ah, there's something over there. Right, over to here, and then over to here. Now, I've got the slam thing now, so I totally want to... Ah, I need to do this at speed. So that's going to open, but it's totally going to close again afterwards. So now I've got to... Oh, line up the camera, line up the camera, line up the... No, or completely mess up everything and then die because I'm trapped in an infinite thing of fire. Right, that could have gone better. Right, this time, on here, yep, fine. This time, don't immediately fall off, miss the quill, and also fall onto infinite fire. Okay, that's the thing here. Right, go, and go, and go, and then this way, and it's the bloody camera. As it ever was with 90s platformers, the problem with doing anything at speed is the bloody camera. And gotcha after many, many flipping attempts. Right. Got myself a pagey, job done. And I've unlocked a new tonic, so I've got, I think that's 5 pagies. Nice. Ah, we've also got a weird scanny robot here. Hello, can we talk to you or get your, ow! Okay, fine, whatever, don't be nice then. I thought you were like, you know, Robot-y the robot. Kind of traditional. Ah, I see. The pattern behind him, I just need to recreate that with the beak buster. So person speaking to a fishnet. There's person speaking to a fishnet. Right, so totally need to do that. Yep, and now I need to find slightly excited dog. Where's slightly excited dog? Oh, I'm so bad at this. Oh, there it was. Balls. Okay, now I know where the second one is. So it's fine. Right, so manfish. Now, slightly excited dog into foot giving a thumbs up. That's foot giving a thumbs up. I see that one. That's fine. Into extremely fat gerbil. Extremely fat gerbil is over here. Right, and then that, and then keep going, and then round thing. Round thing giving off something. Where's round thing giving off things? Balls. Where was it? Down at the bottom here. Fine. Okay. I know how this all works now, probably a bit. And then down to the bottom for the final one of this one. Oi, stop that, you. Well, I've been hit, but on the plus side, I've solved the puzzle. I must have just briefly touched the thing there. And one pagey for me. Nice. Now, at this point, I should be able to afford both of this guy's moves. So, sonar shot. What's the controls there? Top choice. Yes, I can afford all your moves. It's fine. Simply use Y to have my purple pal fire devastating blasts of sonar energy. Marvelous. Fire them enemies to stun them or activate sonar totems to... Ah! Okay, that's how we activate the totems we've been seeing everywhere. And the slurp shot too. So basically just grab things and then spit them out. So grab with B and then tap X to spit them out. Gotcha. Now, thanks to that, I can have a chat with this person. So sonar, he wakes up. And as a result, that platform goes smiley. And I can now take it up to the top and get up to the top of the level. Nice. So now we've got... Ah! Now we've got some platforming to do. Lovely. That'll be the molecule that was mentioned to us. Lovely. Now this is a little bit on the interesting side. Are these guys actually... Are they synced together? Oh, oh. Yes. Oh, oh, but missed that one. Okay, hang on. Ride it back. Ride it back and get the quill. Lovely. Run it forward and get this quill. And there we go. Just and forward to you. And I've got myself a molecule or whatever you... Molly-cool. Sorry, never mind. Take me to Dr. Paz for a cool surprise. Is it she's going to turn me into a plant? Because I'm guessing she's going to turn me into a plant. The jumping's actually a little bit crueler than it was in Banjo-Kazooie. Of course, with Banjo-Kazooie, Kazooie had like the flutter ability, which actually kind of slowed you down and gave you kind of a bit of time to correct in the air. Whereas because in this case, it's just a double jump, it's not any slower. So it's actually a bit more tricky to land your precision jumps. Now I see there's a layer above this one. I'm just not sure how I get up to it. Because sure, I see there's things out here, but I don't think I can. Hang on, if I just go up, up, and then round here. No. Don't think I can get round there. So how are we supposed to... Interesting. Now, Vendi, you said you had something for me, didn't you? So I've unlocked Wellard. Gain +1 butterfly health slot. That seems like a good sort of thing, sure. So now I've got one bit of extra health. Lovely. Now, the guy down here. Now I can do the grabbing and spitting thing. I can do his little target range. Grab myself that. And start attacking. Lovely. Capital shooting. Just a few more of the blighters to blast. Now, where are they going to be? They're going to be over there. Lovely. And over there. grab a few more over there and over there. Lovely. And I think I've already hit one of them over there. Now they're starting to... Oh, now you're getting tricky. Right, grab some more of them. And no, not quite. Just fire some over in that direction. That'll do. And oh, you're... That's not fair. Right, lovely. Grab a bit more of that. No. Now they're trying to flipping dodge me. Oh, no. Don't jump off, mind. There we go. Final one taken care of. Top shooting for a couple of run-of-the-mill peasants. I feel like I've prepared you to take on the rest of the corporate minions in the game. Go collect your reward. Marvellous. Get myself a pagey. Right. Dr. Puzz, transform me into a plant so the plants will actually stop being sniffy towards me. And turn on the ray, and I am being microwaved into, yes, as I suspected, a plant. A plant with flipping... That's not a T-Rex. Oh well, you could always use X to fire your plant spray. I'm sure it will come in useful. I'm sure it will too, because there's plants over there. Hey, hot stuff, come over here and pay me some... Oh, this just got weird. This just got so weird, and I'm no longer comfortable playing this game. And in this mode, I don't have a double jump. Or much in the way of an attack aside from just spraying pollen, which is, yeah, kind of just plant sex, isn't it? This is really weird. Hey, handsome. I haven't seen you around here before. My plant sister's nearby. I could do with a strapping flora like you in their lives. Oh, blimey. If you could help my sisters grow, I'll reward you with a romantic gift. What do you say? Oh, go on then. Do you not want to be sprayed yourself? It's a bit early for that kind of thing. Oh, dear. Right, so, basically, spray these, and now I just need to get the rest of them done. Except, I don't have a proper double jump anymore. So this is going to be a bit tricky to do. Right, I think before I do this, I need to be in Yooka Laylee form in order to... Oh, hang on. Unless I can... Do these plants help me in some way? No. I think I need to break these crates to create a little thing I can drop down via. So I need to transform back and then transform into a plant afterwards again. So back to Yooka Laylee. Now, like this, I can go over here. Hang on. Up, up, and up again. So now I can break this. So now that now is... That's now there. Do I want that to be there? That's probably... No. No, I shouldn't have done that. I should have just pushed them over to here to get over to this one. Because now that one's going to be tricky to get to. Because I could probably... Actually, no. If from here, the plant can jump over there, then the plant must be able to jump over there as well, surely. Yeah, because everything's exactly where I left it. So now I can, well, actually I can't even get on top of that thing, so that doesn't help much. Ah, never mind, a bit of a kind of loose spray just in that direction actually helped out. Can I just, yeah, okay, fine, I can actually jump while I'm spraying, so I need to start spraying first. So spray and then jump, that's good enough. Now, question is, wait, where's number six? Did I see one? I think I might have seen one over here, just hidden around the corner, didn't I, earlier? Nope, just need to get, bloody hell, being a plant is difficult. They're not kind of well suited for moving around. Here it is. Lovely. Plant spray. Nice. Thanks for helping my sisters grow hot stuff. You certainly swooped them off their roots. You better have a pagey in there, by the way. Pagey for me. Huzzah. Now, there's a few more plants floating around, if I recall correctly. And you guys... Do you guys care about plants? You don't seem to care about plants much. Yes, there's one over there. Fine. There's one plant over there that probably wants to be spoken to by another plant. Hello there. Apparently, I'm sexy by plant terms, so hello there, lovely. How are you, beautiful? Hey, hotness, don't tell that lizard a bat, but there's a butterfly booster hidden halfway up the monument in the expanded version of this world. Expanded version of this world? What's an expanded version of this world? Don't tell the lizard and bat, there's a special move extender hidden at the top of the monument in the expanded version of- Ah! The trigger to revealing the secret is quite well hidden though. I don't think you'll ever spot it. Right, I suspect I need to step outside and have a little chat with the Book of One, or the One Book, whatever it was called. I basically need to leave this world, I think. Have a little chat outside of this world and see where that goes. So I suspect the spell book is going to give me a way to expand this world somehow, which is kind of interesting. And while going around as a plant, I re-remembered where I'd seen one of those things. Here we are. There's one of you over here. Wake you up with a sonar blast. No. Left without me, you bastard. Right, there we go. Right now, and get up here. Now I can start navigate. Ah, sorry, there's one over there. Fine, so sonar blast you. That now becomes a real platform. Up here. Now I just need to wait for the timings to be right, because yeah, the platforms aren't perfectly synced. They're blatantly sort of, there we go. And then we've got one over there. That's got you. Now, what have you just woken up for me? Is that, I think it was that one over there. Fine, so I need to wait for, ooh, that's going to be it. That's a tricky one. Getting into the tricky stuff here, and that's just about right. Up we go. Wake you up. You open up the cage. And one page up here. Nice. And from here, we get a very nice view of... Yeah, now, how do I get up to the very top there? How am I supposed to be getting up to the very, very top? Because there's clearly something going on up top, including some more quills. So how do we get up there? Because the plant doesn't really lead up there, as far as I can tell. Ooh, it's very pretty. It's very, very pretty indeed. But yeah, expanded version of this world. That's interesting. Okay, let's get out of here. And then probably try to avoid dying if possible. Good, good. Grand terms of this one here can be expanded using the power of the pages you found. Choosing to expand will make the book world bigger and full of extra challenges to discover. Sounds cool. How does it work? Once you've found enough of those pages, it's up to you if you want to use them to expand a grand tome you've already opened or search Hivory Towers for a brand new one to unlock with us. Okay, interesting. Now that we are back over here... Ooh, one, my spin attack is replaced with fire breath when I've eaten one of these things. I'm guessing after I ate the ice fruit, it was actually ice breath instead, so that's nice. Hello, I'm going to set you on fire now. I know you literally just work here and you're not actually evil or anything, but whatever. Right, now just to light all of these in the right order. Hang on, no. Grab some more fire fruit. Page G. No, the I, not the E. Ow, for goodness sake. And final one. Light the torches in the order of pagey with the fire breath off the fire fruit, and I get a pagey. And now, oh blimey, the book has indeed got quite a lot bigger. But I'm guessing, does that actually make any new, like, jiggies available? No, not jiggies. Pagies, not jiggies. Literally, I cannot get out of the Banjo-Kazooie mindset. It's impossible. You expanded the world. Come and find me and my friends. Okay, that path I saw originally had... All right, fine. So there's a new temple over there. Got it. There's some new stuff. There are actually new pages. Fine. So the first version of the world that you start with isn't all the pages, or indeed all of the... Oh, blimey. So the game wasn't kidding about the whole extra challenges thing. Now there's... Oh, yeah. You know what? This I like better. Yes. Right. Where's the ridiculously tall thing? And now at the top of that big pyramid I climbed before and couldn't find the way up to the very top. Halt, puny lizard. The great Rampo is not interested in thine door-to-door sales. Turn back or face thy doom. No. This is way more exciting. I'm coming for you now. Oh, the great Rampo has no need for thine double-glazed windows. Now, what do I need to do? I think I need to basically sneak up on you and you're going to toss things down at me, aren't you? So obviously grab ourselves a flipping one of you. Now... Go into this, and now avoid... Oh, flip. Okay. Avoid the things. Gotcha. Think I see what you're going on for here. So you're just going to be tossing wood up there, and I don't think I can jump over it. I think you've just got to avoid it. Luckily, I think this area is just spawning more butterflies, which is marvelously good news. Now, can you jump at all? No, I really think you can't because of the slope. Right, and then up to the top. Oh, yes, up to the top. Okay, just up to the top. But now concerns. Now concerns about... How do I get the... Oh, no, you bastard! How do I defeat you, Rampo? Also, that's not fair. You're hitting me on the bloody way down. But stop it! The great Rampo, I'm going to leave you be. Me and you, we're fine. You know what I'm going to go do? I'm going to climb the tallest thing in the world. Right, so, round on the new open paths, and now... Need to navigate through this area behind all of this wire mesh or whatever. Right. Through here, through to here. And what is this? Hello. I found a butterfly pendant. The amazing health extender. Ooh. Collectors to extend health. Yes, that would be logical. And step through the door around the corner, and suddenly we're up here, and oh dear. You're going to be Minecarty the Minecart, aren't you? My job is to ride the rails of them grand tomes and bring back gold. I'm not seeing much treasure in a long time. Nobody cares for us minecart fellas no more. So he would like to be partners on a minecart ride. Oh dear. The thing is, Banjo-Kazooie is an utter classic and didn't have any minecarting in it. DK64 had plenty of minecarting in it and is deeply more flawed than Banjo-Kazooie. I feel like there must be a connection here. Oh, go on, we'll give it a go at least. And if I want to page each 60 gems on the track before we get to the end, alright. A to jump, X to fire, analog stick, boost or break. Gotcha. Right, through here, through here, through here. Watch out for things that probably breathe fire. Jump on that. I need to, oh, flip, hit a few things there. Only need 60, you say? And then forward. Jump through, through, through. Through there, and through there. And I've probably taken some damage. Ah, screw it, if I occasionally ride him through. Ah, you lose things by hitting the... No, dear. I've got all the timings in the world wrong. Through here, avoid you, slightly avoid you, completely fail to avoid you and, you know what, that's still over 60. And with that, pages up. Beautiful. Now let's just head higher and higher and higher here. And we've got, whoa, it's a bit windy up here. Yes, indeed it is. Can I just roll through? And maybe, kind of. Oh, I'm being batted around like crazy, but yes, you can just about, oh dear. Okay, there's a trick to high wind at high altitude. Gotcha. In fact, I feel like I get it already. There are clearly, like, some cannonballs or whatever right here. If I was just to, like, eat one of those, I'd be much heavier. But perhaps I don't have the move to do that yet. Meanwhile, over to the right of where I started. Well, one, we've now got fire fruit here. Maybe we always did. But yes, now we can help just fry this guy a bit better. Lovely. And hello there, Shovel Knight. What exactly are you doing here? Because I feel like you shouldn't really be here so much. I'm the one they call Shovel Knight and I'm having an eventful day. Look, how many do you want and where are they? There appears to be some alluring treasure hidden at the top of this temple. However, I'm having trouble reaching it. Haven't gotten used to this bizarre third dimension yet. Oh, Shovel Knight. Retrieve the giant jewel for me and I'll reveal to thou the secret to succeeding in any adventure. Alright, I also want a pagey. Ah, oh dear, we've now got seesaw-based puzzles. Right, okay, now go. And like that, and then over here. And then like that, and beautiful. Okay, I like myself some seesaw physics. That's always welcome. Ah, this one's a little bit more interesting. Maybe we could just actually just, yeah, stop this for a second. Right, Amy mode, please. There we go. That seems about right. Now, I'm guessing we need to get these guys spinning again, in fact. So, get going. Yep, lovely. And now... Okay, yeah, now we need to go to... Oh, blimey. Okay, this is going to be a bit on the interesting side. If I kind of go to here... If I go to... Ah, wait. Yes, there probably is, right? And about there. Yep, that'll do the job. Fine. Right, up, up. And now up, up. Okay, and up, up. Lovely. Now, round here. Got to figure out the exact right moment to have all of these guys stop. And it's going to be about there. I think. Ooh. Do we have to also do it for the others too? And that. It wore off. Okay, that's about right for that one. Now I just need one for this one. That's rubbish. There we go. That'll do for that one. Question is, how do we get up to. That last one is. How do we. Ah! Down there. Down there. That's fine in that case. That will. That's probably not good enough. A bit more like. Not even, you know what, that'll do. Right, up, and up, and then up to the top, and I've got myself, ooh, hello, are you bad guys? Oh, I feel like you're doing bad things. Right, okay, hang on. Now we just put you down to, yeah, there you go. You don't like being shot with the ice things. And I think they're actually going to be back in time as well. They're trying to flipping reform or something. Right, now just quickly if we can we knock that out? Yep, knock that out. Lovely. Now grab that. Got ourselves that. And now return that to Shovel Knight. Impressive. I can't wait to exchange the jewel for piles of gold. Now, as promised, here's the secret to adventuring success. Is it a shovel? All you need is a map and the thirst for adventure. That's good advice, Shovel Knight. And with that, I get myself a brand new pagey. You know what, ladies and gentlemen, I think you get the point. This here is Banjo-Kazooie. And I don't mean that to, like, you know, mock it or make fun or call them unoriginal or anything. Like, you know, they literally created this project as Let's Do Banjo-Kazooie. And they have. This is pretty much Banjo-Kazooie. Like, you know, lots of it is incredibly similar. Like, even the way that flipping Laylee taunts and teases Yooka when you're just keeping the character standing still is exactly like Kazooie used to do to Banjo. The level design is similar, arguably not quite as good. Like, the thing is, Banjo-Kazooie and Super Mario 64 were both carried by really, really good level design. Whereas, say, Banjo-Tooie and DK64 aren't as fondly remembered because the levels are largely unmemorable. Like, you know, if you had an N64 and you played all those platforms that era, you can probably still remember roughly how Rust Bucket Bay goes, but I bet you can't tell me anything about Grunty Industries in Banjo-Tooie because those levels were a bit too big and maze, like they weren't quite well designed enough. And this has got maybe a little bit of the Banjo-Tooie's about it. So I'd say arguably it's, well, I was about to say it's not as good as Banjo-Kazooie. Yeah, but it works a lot better because of, you know, now you've got two analog sticks with a camera, which makes it a lot better. So the camera's nowhere near as awkward as it used to be on the N64. And, you know, the fact everything's nice and smooth does make a difference. And I don't know, nostalgia makes this a really difficult one to evaluate. I can't really kind of, you know, review or give this a score or anything like that. It's pretty much plain and simple. Do you fondly remember and wish you could play more Banjo-Kazooie? If so, you will love this game. Were you never into platforms in the 90s or you found them a bit frustrating? You probably won't like this game. Pretty much purchase this game entirely on the basis of how much you liked Banjo-Kazooie. And yeah, I honestly, I'm not sure it's going to be kind of winning anyone over one way or the other than that. But yes, there you are, ladies and gentlemen, Yooka Laylee. I probably won't play any more of this because honestly, I find like games like this, while I enjoy playing them myself, I don't think they necessarily make good videos because like there's a lot of exploring and platforming and doing bits over and what have you. So you probably won't see this on the channel anymore. But yeah, take my recommendation, I'd say, for what it is. Pretty much, if you like this sort of thing, you'll like this sort of thing. If you don't, you won't. Probably pretty obvious really going into this, so I'd say that's probably true. Some people, when I said I was originally doing Yooka Laylee on Twitter, they were like, oh no, that game's a total garbage fire. I think that was kind of partly on the basis of, say, Jim Sterling's review gave this 2 out of 10. I think that's unduly harsh. I agree. I don't think it is, like, you know, up there with the best of Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, Banjo-Kazooie, but I certainly don't think it's anywhere near a 2 out of 10 disaster. But I do think, unless you've got the nostalgia for this sort of thing, you probably won't necessarily get that much out of it. So there you are, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure we'll look at more platforms in the future. But in the meantime, I've been John. This has been many a true nerd, and this has been Yooka Laylee. Thank you very much, and goodbye. Just got to weaken the base of this a little bit more. Yes! Yes! Good news, I'm protecting you! Alex Mason, the man who can literally run as fast as a speeding truck. This game is basically just badasses don't look at explosions the game, isn't it? Oh!